What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Lady Man here, aka Lifestyle, aka God Thun Sun here. Y'all know the deal. We're back with a video. We're back with another UFC 4 Mike Rimmer with Chica Blessing. And man, oh man, we finally made it to the championship. Now, before we get into today's video, I want to say something real quick. I know a lot of you guys are expecting, you know, to me to record more of Chica, than Aiden, but then the black says Aiden. But if I'm being honest, the only reason why I'm recording this with Chica is because I want to get straight to the women's part as quick as I can to get her done and over with, you know what I'm saying? And all that. And on top of that, you know what I'm saying, you know, I just want to get into the big picture here. And obviously is this the UFC championship. And of course it's in the flyweight women's division. I think that's brand new. They're brand new in this game. Because we had strongweight and bantamweight. Now we have flyweight is the brand new division. Of course, Valentina I love this fighter, but I cannot pronounce her last name. Valentina Shevchenko. That's Shevchenko. That's the only thing that's the good best thing I can pronounce the name. And in today's video, we're going up against her for the flyweight women's championship UFC flyweight women's championship. This is huge because, you know, not only are we going against a great fighter, which is called Valentina Shevchenko, but also she's holding a belt that Chica has never held before, the flyweight. Some of you guys may not know this. Flyweight, I think it was new this year or a couple years ago. I'm not sure when the flyweight women's came in, but I do remember that it was new a couple years ago. And of course, Valentina Shevchenko took over, and now she's champion. So we got Amanda Nunes taking over the bantamweight. We got Thug Rosa, you know what I'm saying? We got Thug Rosa taking over the strawweights. Now we got Valentina Shevchenko taking over the flyweights. Those three are one of my favorite fighters, or women's fighters in the UFC. I like all three of them. Awesome, man. So that's the whole point. But the whole point here is that the African Queen is going against Chica, or the African Queen is Chica Blessing is going against Valentina Shevchenko for her flyweight championship. I'm super excited for this one because this is going to be a really good fight. I faced her last time in UFC 3, and I was in strawweight, I do remember, and she put up a really, really good fight. I'm not going to lie. And hopefully that she put up a better one than UFC 4. Because like I said before, I just want to get straight to the good stuff with Chica and not the all boring fighting stuff. I just want to get the good stuff. The only reason I did it for Aiden is just so you guys would be interested more than that, than the Aiden series than the Chica series. Because the whole point of Chica series is to get straight to the belt, and that's where we're going with Chica, is getting straight to the belt. And she has progressed a lot, and I'll show you all her perks and all that type of stuff before we even get to the belts in today's video and all that, because there's a lot of things. I always forget to do it with Aiden, and I keep messing up. But then when I do it with Chica, I'm just all set and ready. I don't know why, but anyways, that's not the whole point here. Her point here is in today's video, obviously we're gonna go against Shevchenko. We got trained for this fight, and obviously we're gonna accept this fight. And this is a really huge fight because we climbed up the ranks. And but before we get to the fight, I gotta show you guys what I've been working on with Chica. Obviously, she's a 3-star fighter, and the evolution point is 59. I have been saving up the evolution points just to upgrade Chica and all that to the best of her ability, and her accuracy, her blocking, all the head movements, not that great. Kick power is okay, but her punching power and her speed power, punching power and punching speed, it's all good. Her takedown defense is terrible. The switch stands, so not that great. I'm not gonna lie, I am really terrible when it comes to upgrading both of these characters. I ain't gonna lie. The strength is 3.5 stars. Everything else, all these are 3.5 stars. I don't even know if I'm gonna upgrade these because I think I like it where they are. But hey, it is what it is. The grappling, you guys already know, it sucks. It's really not that good. My whole point here is to get her stand up really good, but I don't know how I'm gonna get her good, considering you know, it's probably impossible here to get her good with her stand up. But hey, at least I can get her kick power up. But her kick speed and power cost so much, so I don't know why, but It don't matter though. I'm probably gonna get these up and then like leave the kick power for Chica to Aaron and just focus on these for now, and then yeah, that's it. But the moves. I'm gonna show you guys real quick. So some of you guys may not know is I have this brand new moves that I want to show you guys. The uppercuts all four stars that are really good. The straights and jabs and all the three stars. The hooks are three stars and all that. You know, these are not that important, but guess what? Look at this. So some of you guys may not know is I made Chica and you know, of course, Aiden both boxers, and with the boxers, you know, they got overhands, and let's just say I've been using really good with the overhands with Chica more than Aiden, you know what I'm saying? But because I just love the overhands. The overhands are just so nice, and because of that, I've been using a lot with the overhands. I now going to prestige him, you know what I'm saying? All I need to do is get two knockouts with this move at level 5 in order to prestige it, which is cool. Now, I think it gets you prestige it. I guess you make it get more powerful for the overhand. I'm not sure. I did prestige the cartwheel kick for Aiden. I'm sure y'all know stuff about that in Aiden series, and it was really cool that I upgraded that one, the cartwheel one. It was really cool. Really cool knockouts I got with that one. Like, that was really amazing. Now we're doing, that was the kick for Aiden. Now we're going to do the hands for Chica and get her overhand, you know, prestige level, you know what I'm saying? Because she's a really good knockout, she really got good knockout powers. I mean, all her powers and speeds are 5 stars. So that's really good. But other than that, there's more too. No, not the perks. Not the perks. So the perks, obviously, you guys already noticed, the roundhouse is all 3 stars, but if you keep it looking going down, I'm not worrying about, don't care about these. All right, guess what I got? The rolling thunder. Check this out. Look at this. You see that? The rolling thunder kick. I have no idea who does the rolling thunder kick in the UFC. I have no idea who does that, but whoever made the decision of putting this kick in, I appreciate that, because this kick is so amazing. Hopefully, if I could get a knockout with, I'm probably going to get a knockout with probably Valtteri with this one, because what greater way of taking her title by my knockout with this rolling kick. Like, this is so hilarious. Like I think you guys are going to really enjoy with that rolling thunder kick. So I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to try to knock her out with this rolling thunder kick and let the overhand, you know, damage her a lot and all that. But anyways, I still have the, so the rolling thunder kick, we're going to use that one. I still have the jumping kick though. What's that jumping kick called? The leading jumping kick. I got it at 4 stars. I don't plan on upgrading it. I'm not going to lie. I plan on not upgrading this because I want to focus more on getting the thunder kick, you know, upgraded. Who knows? I might actually prestige the rolling thunder, but not the jumping lead kick. The reason why is because the jumping lead kick, every time I try to get a jumping lead kick, it's not accurate. it's not accurate. Maybe because I don't put my accuracy up when it comes to punching, kicking, or jabbing. Maybe I need to get those up. Those upgraded, but regardless, it still won't matter. It still won't be. It's not that accurate like it used to be back in UFC 2. But hey, though, we got it. We're still gonna keep it though, and yeah, that's pretty much it. And the rolling thunder though, I'm probably gonna use that a lot more often than the jumpy lean kick, and all that. But and then of course, you already know the overhand. I have to use that. But anyways, everything else, the clinch takedowns. The clinch takedowns, ground, nothing really has changed. For real. I mean, there are 2 stars and 1 stars. I really do not care much about the, I mean, the combos, they're great and all. Combos are great, but I don't know how to do combos in this game, because I suck at these games, but yeah, it is what it is. But that's not the whole point. That's pretty much it for the Chica, you know, basically, the whole attribute and all that. Like I said, you know what I'm saying, we're going to try our best to beat Valentina Shevchenko, take her flight weight, and then Chica will finally hold all 3 titles. Now, she has won the strawweight before, she has won the bantamweight before, and now she's going to have a possibility of winning a flight weight, which is the new title that's in the women's division in UFC, so I'll be gladly to take that, you know, that title. But we got to beat Valentina in order to do that. But anyways, we're going to head to the Valentina fight. And yeah, I'll catch y'all there. Also, before we get, I have to do something before we get to another video. I mean, before we get to the fight again, I really apologize, but I want to show you something real quick. Obviously, I'm 24-0 with Chica. These are all the people I went up against to go against, you know, to beat, you know, to go like against Valentina for the championship. I have no idea who these women are. I really don't know who they are, but I'm pretty sure some of y'all MMA fans out there will know who these women are. I don't know these women from flyweight, but from strawweight to the bantamweight, I know some of the women's. But none of these women, I had no idea who they were, who they are. I don't know if they're real or not. But I beat all these women in order to get to the flyweight women's championship, UFC championship against Valentina. Now I will say this though, if you did your My Career Mode with your first character, they're gonna give you the option to either you can just skip the Dana White's contender series and just go straight to UFC and fight there. And I did end up doing that. I ended up skipping the Dana White series, contender series, just skip on over to UFC. However, I started to regret that because it took me a lot longer than to get the title opportunity than it was with, getting into the contender series, because I did it with Aiden. I put him in a contender series. It took him until his 18th or 19th, maybe his 20th fight, in order to get an opportunity for the UFC middleweight championship. And he went on to have that huge fight with Dominic Reyes with the UFC lightweight championship. It took me at least 20 fights. At least 20 fights with Aiden. This one, Pachika, it took me 24. The reason why it took me over that long is because I literally skipped ahead of the contender series. I didn't want to continue series, and I ended up just going straight over to UFC, and I ended up winning the fights, but it took a lot longer for me to get an opportunity for the championship than it was with Aiden. But hey though, it doesn't matter. We got Chica, we got her the championship. She got the women, she get an opportunity to face our team for the women's flyweight championship, and I'm super excited for it. She can hold a title that she's never hoping for. That's the flyweight championship. And we beat Valentina, we will get that title. So, anyway, without further ado, let's get to the fight for real this time.
Man, it's crazy. Seems like just yesterday you stand up at the posters all wide-eyed. You've been through a lot. Hell, I put you through a lot. But it was all for one reason, to get you here. Your first UFC championship. I just want to say, no matter what happens out there, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of the fighter you've become. Yeah, don't get me wrong though. If you lose, I'ma have to bust you up in the gym next week. I already made space on the wall for a new picture, and you know how much I hate redecorating, right? So let's go get that belt, champ.
Let's do it.
Yes. Oh, here we go.
All right, so here she is, the UFC women's flyweight contender, looking to become the new champion here tonight. There is no denying she has every tool.
I would say though, if you look at right here, to her chest area, you would notice that her tire is black. I think it's a glitch in the game to where it doesn't show her the UFC attire. I think it's a glitch in the game because look, you see right here. Her shorts, it's showing the UFC, the Viper stuff, Venom stuff, for her black attire showing all that. I think it's because of the glitch in the previous PlayStation 4, but in PlayStation 5, I guess it's everything's all completely fine. I don't know. It's just confusing, but it doesn't matter. We just need to focus on winning this fight.
All right, so here she is. Here she is. Women's flyweight champion, all smiles,
Jeff Chago.
Looking to go out the way she came in as the undisputed champion at 125 pounds. Most people believe it is going to take a huge effort from one of these fellow contender types to dethrone this UFC women's flyweight champion. Let's see how she does in this defense here.
Striker, black belt. She a black belt, man. Okay. We just can't go to the ground with Valentina. That's it. We just got to fight her to a We just gotta fight her, you know, to the top. We just gotta fight her or stand up. We just got to.
Our tail of the tape for this, our
here we go.
Event of the evening.
She's 38 years old and she's still fighting? Okay, whatever.
When it comes to the age,
I'm 5'8", she's 5'5". I have reach.
We sent it inside the octagon. Here's Bruce Buffer.
So we're good here. All right, Bruce, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for.
Look at her breast attire. It just doesn't. I don't know why they messed that up. I don't know why EA messed that up. I don't know why it's a glitch, but it don't matter. I don't know.
Introducing first,
the Africa Queen, Chicken Bussing.
This woman is a boxer, holding a professional record of 24 wins, no losses. She stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 116 pounds. Fighting out of Cape Town, South Africa, presenting the challenger, Bam Bam.
The Africa Queen, Chicken Bussing. Let's go. Here we go.
This woman is a Muay Thai fighter, holding a professional record of
29 wins,
3 losses. Mm-hmm. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in at 120
pounds. Afghanistan. Okay.
Fighting out of Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan.
I think that's Germany, if I'm correct. I don't know.
Undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world.
Valentina and the Gunner.
Bullet.
Shav Jake. Okay, so I was right at the beginning. Okay. I got her name at the beginning at first. Here we go.
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Have a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves. Back your corners. Come out fighting.
Here we go.
And we are underway.
Ready?
All right, here we go.
Round one is underway, and she is as devastating a knockout threat as this
round
division
one
has ever seen. If you want proof,
this fight's going to be real tense.
Recent highlight reel, 3 straight wins, all of them by
flush knockout.
Oh, man. We'll see if she can keep it going.
Oh, man, this is so tense, and of course, I cannot let her take me down. I got to stand up.
A beautiful double jab. That thing's going right from the chin.
Come on.
Nice punch by Shevchenko.
Oh my goodness.
Oh!
Got him with the kick.
Edge of your seat action at all.
Oh, got with the overhand. She's down.
She can't take pictures now.
She's
she
not
has
all the way down. Oh no, not the.
Back to the
I hate when she takes it down.
Just missed with the left there.
Oh, wow.
All right, so again, the fighters clinch here. Kind of had an inkling we'd find ourselves back in this situation.
Got him.
Absolutely. Whoa!
Got her again. Oh, got her again. Oh.
Oh. Oh,
oh, she looks like she's done. Oh, now mine. Wow. That's
back
like a fourth knockdown I think I got with her.
Again, she chooses to clinch here.
Oh, my gosh.
Secures the takedown.
See, there it is. She switched.
Well, it's one thing to be confident in.
Nope.
Man.
Got her again. Ooh, roll thunder again.
No, what you're going to see with this young lady is
ooh,
she going to finish
nice
the fight.
Nope, defend that.
Striking, great cardio, great fight.
And she lands a punch there. We'll see if she can start to turn these singular strikes into combinations.
I want that roll thunder kick again.
That
ooh, that Superman punch. I knew she was going
to
do it too, but they don't want me.
Gets up again here, but hurting.
Oh,
All right, so once again, they will clinch, and we will see which fighter is able to advance their position from here.
Who's going to be the first one to attempt the takedown? Both of our combatants
have
the ability to score and secure the position.
Oh, got her. Just like that, it's all over.
The fight is over.
Oh, my God. Woo!
If you're trying to send a message to the rest of this division, that is how you send it. So a near-perfect shot for her to end the fight. She had this crowd behind her all night long. And
woo!
I'm not sure
a back-and-forth fight.
This division could have absorbed that strike,
but I got her.
In the fight. A near-perfect land to get the knockout win here tonight.
Another knockout victory.
So there she is,
let's
ladies
go.
And gentlemen, the UFC Women's Flyweight Champion of the World. What a knockout turned in by this 125-pound phenom here tonight.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called us.
That's Chica's third different. She's a three-division champion, technically. Strongweight, bantamweight, and now flyweight.
Oh, there's nothing like it when we crown a new champion tonight. That's what we do in the UFC Women's Flyweight Division. And
let's go.
Her era is now underway.
I mean, her era is underway, and we did not expect this result. We thought she was in for an uphill battle.
Must stand up fight.
Done, man. What a performance to take the title away from a great champion.
You did not expect it.
I didn't expect it, John. And guess what?
Let's go.
You're one of those guys that will change your pick at the end. I'm teaching you good, dog. I'm teaching you good, dog.
Go Saints.
Well, we did it. We beat Chop Jago for the UFC. Championship. You continue this. Oh man. This is amazing. We're seeing this whole thing happening. And new champion. We beat the Bullet Valentina. We beat her. What an uppercut! Look at that. Oh man. I didn't expect that uppercut. I literally just pressed that button and then it came out of nowhere. It was amazing. And new champion, finally. Unfortunately, her bra doesn't show the UFC logo on it, but it is all black, but it is what it is. We got the championship, we won, and we did it. Normally I would just defend the title, and normally I do it in flyweight, but I'm just going to just focus on getting to the super fight and just go from there. And we'll just go for there from there, you know what I'm saying? So, we're champions. We won. That's great. We won championship. We are champions. I would love to actually, you know, defend the title. But, like, I think we already proven why we're champions. So, there's no point in that. Next episode, we are going to be going that super fight. And I think it's going to be for the bantamweight championship. So, Chica's gonna go after that once again, and then we're gonna go from there. We basically have to defend our titles just like you know, Aiden did. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty much it, but we're gonna do it off camera. Cause we already experienced so much on this fight and all that. But yeah, that's pretty much it, man. Thank y'all for watching. Leave a like, subscribe. One of a fight. That was a really good fight. You know, we could have gone either way. And yeah. That's pretty much it, man. Thank y'all for watching. And as always, take care. I'm out. Peace. The Africa Queen. Chica Bless is now a flyweight champion. Can you believe that?
The voice of the demon is the voice inside your head. The voice of the demon will make you feel dead. The voice of the demon is 100% real. The voice of the demon is the one you need to kill. The voice of the demon is the voice inside your head. The voice of the demon will make you feel dead. The voice of the demon is 100% real. The voice of the demon is the one you need to kill.